Afternoon, y'all. Woo, I don't know about y'all, but I needed some motivation on this morning. I needed God to put a word in my spirit to let me know what was going on, to give me clarity, to give me confirmation that He has not forgot about me. Like, Lord, I want you to know that I'm hungry. I'm hungry for you. I'm hungry for what you have for me. What they say, my stomach is touching my back, Lord. I'm ready to be fulfilled in this season. So I just want to pray real quick, y'all. So Father God, we just thank you for bringing us together, God. Thank you for giving us clarity, oh God. Thank you for sending us a right now word, Father. Thank you for giving us instructions, God. We thank you. We magnify your name, Father. We just invite your presence unto this video, oh God, and we ask that you give us ears to hear, Lord, eyes to see what you would have us to see, oh God, and give us the spirit, give us the push to be obedient unto your word on today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And I want y'all to know that I already pray across every person that comes across this video, and that with you being obedient to the word of God, that He bless you with your heart's desires. And I truly, truly hope that you guys are praying the same for me. Day 9 of November, baby, it feels like a new year. So I'm gonna just say that it feels like a new year. It feels like January 1st. That's how we know a shift is taking place, has taken place. And God is still doing some shifting and doing some major things in our lives. So I'm coming over here to tell you that He has not forgotten about you. He's going to make sure that you eat. Come on now. He will never leave you nor forsake you. And he's going to provide every need that you're needing. So I want to start by reading the word. And I really want to, before I dive into the message, because you coming across this video today, I ain't even gonna second guess it. Come on now. You like me. You getting worried in your well-doing. Worried about what you're doing. Worried about who you're doing it with. Worried about how it's gonna get done. How it's gonna get funded. How you gonna pay for this. How you gonna do that. And God said, you know, I got you. So let's go to Galatians chapter 6, verse 9 real quick. Because I want to read that to start off. And just bear with me on this word, because, baby, I was waiting on this word, and God has been brewing it in my spirit. So I really want to make sure I take my time and not be long at all, but take my time and make sure we get our portion. Come on now, our portion from this video that God is trying to give to us. So Galatians chapter 6, and I really want y'all to go with me to Galatians just so you are able to read it and comprehend it for yourself as well. Ain't no sense in hearing it. You make sure that the person is reading what's there and exactly what the Lord has said, not what they saying. You want to make sure it's what the Lord is saying and saying to you. So Galatians 6, and we're going to go to verse 9. And it says, and let us not grow weary of doing well, for in due season we will reap if we do not give up. And read it backwards, because you see that verse starts off end. So it's more to it. So I'm going to have you, that's on your time with you and God, you go back and you read what God is trying to tell you. And He says, let us not grow weary of doing well, for in due season we will reap if we do not give up. Whew. Hang on, baby. Hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on. And I want to, you know, jump right into this word. Because I was watching a video earlier before I jump on it. I watched a message. It just came across, and she said, before the race, they got to say, get your march, get ready, set, go, right? So it's a process before they say, set and go, before you go. So they say, on your mark, get set, go. So God is telling us, like, right now we in position. So you in position, but, you know, He's getting ready to say, on your mark, get set, go, for you to take off. Right now you just in position. He got you in position. Okay. All right. Come on. I feel it. This is going to be a prophetic word for somebody. You know, I'm just thinking I'm getting on here to give a message. It's already prophetic for me. Come on now, because only you know what you've been praying for. Glory to God. Come on, Holy Spirit. Do what only you know how to do. Shift the room like only you know how to shift it. So we're going to go to Proverbs 24, verse 27. If you have not joined my sisterhood group, Sisterhood Formed by Faith, you definitely want to hook up with us this month. God is doing some amazing things. And of course, we can see right now how his hand is moving. Come on now. But he's even working behind the scenes. Come on. He's working behind the scenes in our lives. He's working behind the scenes in the group. I feel it and I see it. I just know, you know, he's doing something, child. So join us in supporting, empowering, and motivating each other. You could do so by going on Facebook, searching our group, Sisterhood Formed by Faith, and clicking join. We are doing this awesome Proverbs challenge of becoming a virtuous woman, becoming virtuous women, and we are doing it together. Whatever that virtuous woman looks like to you, whatever God has been brewing in your spirit about you and who he has called you to become. Amen. So we're going to go to, and we haven't even got to day 24 yet, but God is just, come on now, he's doing some things rapidly. We haven't even got to day 24 yet, but he's like, okay, I need you to see this. I need you to see where I'm going with this on day 9. Come on now, don't get weary. Come on now, don't look at the other opponents. Don't look at what's going on around you. Come on now, I need you to see you, what lies ahead of you. Glory to God. Come on, y'all. So Proverbs 24, verse 27. And boy, it was just, even a baby can understand it. Like, this was one of those verses. Not all verses hit me like that. Like, sometimes I'll be like, okay, I know I'm a baby. You know, I must be a newborn. You know, when you think about a baby, they got little months on them. I'm a newborn, child. I'm still a zero on some scriptures. I'll be like, okay, Lord, I'm a zero. I'm a newborn. So this is for babies. So I need you to break this down for me because I'm a newborn. So, but this is one of those scriptures, child, that I believe even a newborn can comprehend it. So if you a newborn in the spirit, child, even you are going to catch this word. It's going to resonate with your spirit. It's going to give you clarity. It's going to give you that push. Come on now, that push that I needed this morning. Glory to God. I feel it. Y'all know when I feel that preach coming on, child, I'm going to let the Holy Spirit take us home. Do you hear me? So Proverbs 24, chapter 24, verse 27 says, prepare your work outside. Get everything ready for yourself in the field. And after that, build your house. Woo! Prepare your work outside. Can I just start right there? And you got to catch this in the spirit. Come on now. I need you to get out your flesh. I need you to get out your situation. I need you to get out your own head. I need you to fully submit yourself to God on this video right now. Your attention, everything. I need you to fully submit it right now and catch this in your spirit. Get your work together outside. What do you need to do on the outside? Let God handle the inside, baby. Come on now. Oh, I ain't even gonna go there. Holy Spirit, give it to me on another video. Glory to God. But get the work done outside. Come on now. If you feel like you need to lose weight, get to it. Come on now. If you around the wrong people, come on now. It's time to remove yourself. If you doing the wrong thing, if you thinking the wrong thoughts, come on now. It's time to remove them. If you're not seeing what you want to see this season, come on now. It's time for you to put the work in. It's time for you to take inventory on what it is that you are needing or what it is that you are needing to let go of. Come on now. Woo. The title of this message is your meal is being prepared. Come on now. God said he'll prepare the table in the presence of your enemies. I'm not even studying the fact that he's going to prepare it in the presence of my enemies. I'm focused on the fact that God said he's going to prepare it for me. God saw me, he think I'm that special. He loved me that much that he said, I'm going to prepare the table for you. And then he tells us to not get weary in well doing. Come on now, because he got us. And in due season, we shall reap. So not only are you going to prepare the table for me, God, but you're going to cook the food. You're going to bring it to the table. when you gonna set it before me. I'm not worried about my enemies. Come on now, they just extra to it. Come on now, I knew you was a good God, but you just an even greater God. Come on now, you gonna prepare the table, cook the food. My mama used to make us prepare the table, child. She used to say, go and set the table while she was preparing the meal. But God is such a good God. He said, I'm gonna prepare the table and prepare the meal. That just show us we should be like God. We should be a multitasker. I should be doing more than one thing at a time. Come on now, but it should all tie in together. It should all, you should look at it all and see God's glory in the midst of it. Glory to God. Come on, God, give me this word, how you would have me to give it to your people on today, because I needed this word. Oh, God, I needed this fulfilling. So I know somebody's going to need this word. Come on now. And I want to challenge you to be obedient. Come on now, in the name of God. Come on now, because I feel it in my spirit. Glory to God. Woo. Mm-mm-mm. So then it says, get everything ready for yourself in the field. Come on. And we already saw that last part. It says, after that, build your house. Whew. So when I think about, ooh, because y'all know home ownership and all that has been brewing in my spirit. So when I think about owning my home and it says, get everything together, you know, on the outside, like, if I could picture it before it's being built, okay, I want white cabinets. I want this type of floor. I want this. I want that. And then God says, build your house. You don't want to just build a house and just put anything in it and then you don't like it at the end. No, he said, build your house. Come on now. Gather what you needed in the field. Come on now. And then build the house. All right, if you're trying to start the business, are you going to need a team? What ideals are you going to need? If you're trying to, you know, be in a God-ordained marriage, who you going to be doing it with? Come on now, you might not even know who the person is, but write out those characteristics, traits of who you want them to be. Who are you wanting to be? Come on now. Woo! And when I think about getting weary in my well-doing, I can speak, I can be transparent, I can be open. I've been looking around, seeing, you know, what God's been doing. Coming out, when you're in a race, you get to looking around at the opponents. And of course, we're not in a race with each other. Glory to God. I want you to catch this in the spirit. I want to give you a visual that you can understand in your fleshly standpoint. Come on now. But you got to take it deeper in your spirit. So when you look around, you're like, okay, ooh, she got that. She got the muscles. Boy, she been working out. Ooh, she fit. Ooh, she this. I don't know if I can be able to complete it. But God said, you ain't in a race with what's around you. Come on now. You in your own race. You on my time. Ooh, glory to God, y'all, baby. Baby, ain't no sense in looking at what's around you. Ain't no sense in looking at your opponents. Come on now. What God has for you is going to be for you. Come on now. You've got to be obedient. You've got to be obedient to his words. Don't get weary in your well-doing. I'm not talking about you being nice to this person. You doing well. You doing this. No, don't get worried in your well-doing. Staying faithful. Come on now. Keeping your faith at the forefront of your mind. Glory to God. And while we're talking about your mind, God is so good. Baby, God is so smart. What we don't know, he know. I'm trying to tell y'all that. I be saying that. Well, I don't be saying. Let me rephrase that. I heard the saying, pivot your thinking before, right? I'm laying in the bed, y'all, and boy, I'm trying to keep up. I'm laying in my bed, and I'm having all these negative thoughts come through. Not just negative, but like self-doubting thoughts. Not just doubting myself, but even doubting who God is in a way. Not saying like, oh God, I doubt you. But if I'm not holding on to my faith, then I'm doubting him. Come on now. I'm letting the enemy come in and attack my mind and try to tell me what I can't do. And when I feel like I can't do something, that's denying the power of God that's on my life. That's denying the authority that God has given me. So I'm laying there and you know, letting all the thoughts come in and, you know, contradict what God already spoken to me during prayer, during my Bible readings, last year, whenever the case was, letting the enemy come in, you know, and flooding them. Come on now. But I catch this in the spirit, child. When the enemy comes in like a flood, come on now, God gonna raise up a standard against them. Ooh, and he think he doing something. God gonna say, I still got this. This is my child. Ooh, focus, y'all. So as them thoughts started to come in my mind, I heard the spirit say, pivot your thinking. I'm sitting there like, this ain't me, because I don't even say pivot. I don't even know what pivot means. Can I be real with y'all? And I played basketball. I shot me a little free throw in about fifth or sixth grade, y'all. Your girl was balling. But anyway, so I'm like, I don't know what pivot even means. So I know this is not me. Come on now. You got to know the voice of God. You got to know how the enemy moves. You got to know how you move. Okay. This ain't the enemy, because he want me to be stuck in this negative state of mind. All right. This ain't me, because I don't even know what pivot mean. I don't even know what pivot look like. I don't even know if pivot is word. Matter of fact, I didn't even know how to spell the word pivot. I had to Google it. I had to look it up, okay, in the dictionary. So I said, okay, this is a still voice telling me, because I'm feeling like I can't breathe, that spirit, because I ain't going to claim it, that spirit of anxiety tried to creep in, you know, because we was once cool. We used to hang out at a point in time, you know, anxiety used to drive me to places. Fear used to hang out with us, and we would let fear drive sometimes, word of God. But now that I learned the voice of God and still learning, because it's a process, baby, come on. He who starts a work in you won't finish till the day of Jesus Christ. Come on now, till your days is up, he won't stop working on you. We are his workmanship. Come on now, we are his craft. Come on now, he created us in his image and in his liking. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come on now, think higher. So I get in that dictionary, and I spelled pivot wrong, you know, because I'm on dictionary on my phone. I spelled pivot wrong, but you know, they come with, you know what you mean, you keep on searching. They say, did you mean? And I'm like, all right, that might be it, but it looked like pivot. And I'm like, okay, because I'm being transparent, I'm being open, you know, I'm being real. Come on now, I'm from Kansas City, Missouri, you know, I grew up in the public school district. They don't make us no less, but you know, I wasn't focused on that stuff. I was focused on some other things. If I keep it real, if I keep it 100 with y'all, but God is such a good God, he don't call the people who are equipped. Come on now, he equipped the calling. Glory to God. I'm trying to tell you, baby, that's you know what, let me focus, y'all. So I get on there, and I look up the word pivot, and I finally get to the right word. And God is so good, because he knows sometimes we won't just understand by reading something. I need a visual, I need an image. That's just me. I'm a scenery type of person. I have to see some things. So glory to God. Ooh. So I went, y'all, he just blowing my mind in this video. Like, I don't know about y'all, but you gotta catch this in the spirit, baby. Ooh, glory to God. Holy Spirit, give me focus, give me a sound mind. Glory to God. Woo. So a video ended up popping up, and it was a basketball, you know, it was a lady, she was playing basketball, and it was teaching you. Woo, Rabbi Jesus, my teacher, getting that word, he will teach you. God. Okay, I have to stay focused, y'all. So it was a girl, she was in position, you know, playing, and they was teaching her how to pivot. Woo, God is teaching us how to pivot, how to move this season. I'm going to get this out. So in order to pivot, you can't stay flat-footed. That was one of the first things I heard in the video. You can't stay flat-footed. And when I said, you know, God, what you trying to have me to catch in the spirit? He said, you can't stay still. You can't stay in that same spot. You can't stay in that same position after you pray. Come on now. After you pray, you have to position yourself. Come on now. And they say you have to lift up. Ooh, and push forward. That's the one I was watching. You got to lift up and push forward. But when I caught out the vision of pushing forward, okay, because I'm asking God for clarity in the midst. All right, God, what you mean? And what, you know, what you trying to show me here? He like, all right, after you pray, you can't stay stuck. You cannot stay flat footed. You got to lift up. You got to lift your thoughts up. You got to lift your spirit up, and you have to push forward. And when I think about pushing forward, you have to push your thoughts on what's forward, on what you see in your future. You have to push your now into your future. Okay, this is what it's looking like, but I have to push this into something else. Glory to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for bringing this back to me. Some of us are in position. We are thinking forward. Come on now. We are standing in the promise, but the promise ain't looking like the promise. Glory to God. And we about to get up off of here. Come on now. Woo! This was quick, hot, and off the press. All right, catch your focus, babe. Catch your focus. Okay, so the promise ain't promising. Come on now. It ain't looking like the promise. But God said, I'm just preparing the table right now. Woo! How you want me to say this, Holy Spirit? God said, he's just preparing the table right now. And I gave another message about your enemies ain't going nowhere, and God is bringing me clarity on why. Because he's still preparing the table. He ain't even called us to eat yet. Woo! He ain't even called us to eat yet. You know what? I feel like it's going to be a part two to this. Glory to God. It's going to be some testimonies up off of this. Bear with me. God said he's just preparing the table. He said, you seeing right now, I'm just preparing the table. And I took some notes because it was some important parts that, you know, I did not want to miss, because he was just giving it to me. And I already was, you know, having my own little, so I had to stay focused. I'm like, all right, I know when God tell me to write something down that, you know, he wants someone to hear it exactly like this. So when he said he's just preparing the table, preparing your table, your life is your table. And you know, he's setting it. Oh, glory to God. Let me breathe, y'all. Whew. So he said he's having you gather who you gonna do it with. Where you gonna do it at? You gathering. You doing some gathering right now. Glory to God. You changing your thoughts. You gathering. You gathering yourself. You know he's getting you prepared in the midst of preparing your table. Will somebody catch this in the spirit? Glory to God. You are making a list of what you need. If you haven't, you need to, after watching this video, make a list of what you need this season. Glory to God. And of course, you always have your vision board and your future list, but God wants to know what it is you are in expectancy of this season. Now, according to his riches and his glory, but come on now, he's saying, gather or make a list if you haven't already gathered. This for two different people, two different sets of people, groups, whatever you want to call it. Children of God, this for two different sets. I don't know how to, you know, explain it. Okay, I'm just leave that like that. So this is for two different people, God is telling me. Two different groups, two different worlds or whatever. So some of us have already gathered where we going to do it at, who we going to do it with, right? That's our prep. You know, he's preparing our table right there. And some of us, God is telling us to write down what we need this season. Write down the characteristics of the people that we want to do it with, whether it's a business partner, whether it's a spouse, whether it's friendships, whether it's your family. Write it down. Like, I need them to be loving. I need them to be compassionate. That part, okay? And for us over here, gather who you need to do it with. You already know who they are. Write their names down. Make it plain. Make the vision plain. What do you need this season? Same mind. Funds. Write it down. So one group, they have an idea of what they want, right? But God hasn't given y'all clarity. On the other hand, God has given us clarity. So it's two different groups. Catch that. Now catch this. Okay, well, let's stop right there. Preparing for a better outcome. So I feel like this is for, it could be in between, okay? Y'all, I don't have all the answers. I just have to say how God gave it to me. So preparing for a better outcome. Looking forward to what's to come, not what you used to seeing, not how you used to doing it, but just a better outcome and knowing that God knows what's best. He gave me this in the spirit, child. Get away from certain people. So some of us is around people who cannot see our vision, cannot handle our vision, cannot handle our calling, cannot handle the hand of God that's on our lives. Either jealousy, either not understanding, either not having that relationship with God. I don't know. Only you will know. And get in prayer. Glory to God. So getting away from those certain people and getting around like-minded people, people who support the vision, people who see the vision, people who have tools to, you know, go hand in hand with your vision. Glory to God. Stay close to those people in this season. And I'm going to leave it right there because, you know, that's all the Holy Spirit has given me. And that was enough for me. I received my portion from this video and I know you receive your portion as well. I have been seeing 11, 11, 11, 1, like new beginnings, number one, first place. That, thank you, Holy Spirit, first place. You're going to be first place in some things. Glory to God, not in competition with other people. You're going to be first place in your life. Your life is going to be number one for you. You're going to get a trophy in your life. Glory to God. Whatever that means to you, you know, catch it in the spirit. So, y'all know I normally don't have you sow a seed or whatever, but God put it in my spirit and I trust him and I have to be obedient, even though, you know, my head will tell me, you know, don't do that, don't do this. But God wants to see our obedience in this season because he wants to do great things in our lives. He wants to bless us according to our heart's desire. He said it's his good pleasure to bless us beyond measures. Come on, I caught that in the Holy Spirit. It's his pleasure to bless us beyond measures. More than we could ask for, exceedingly and abundantly. He is the God of exceedingly and abundantly. more than what we could have ever even asked for, because we haven't even thought about it. Neither has it even entered into our hearts. Glory to God. Thank you, Father, for this moment. And whew, God, I pray over any person who hears your voice during this video, oh God, who sees none of me, but hears all of you, oh God, and take they last, oh God, and plant the seed on good ground, oh God, not trusting in me, oh God, not trusting in my words, oh God, but trusting in what you have already put in their spirits, oh God. You just use me, oh God, to confirm it. But you have already been giving them visions, oh God. You have already been telling them some things. You have already been brewing some things in the spirit. Come on now. And I think about a steak. Woo! I think about a steak. God said, you ain't delayed. He have not forgotten about you. Some people like their steak medium rare. But you like your steak well done. That's why he sent you on my video, because you like me. Look, you like your steak well done. Come on now. You, when you put that roast in the crock pot, you want it tender. God said, that's why you seeing everybody else plates being brought out. Glory to God. And you looking around like, okay, I'm hungry. When is my plate coming out? When is it going to be my turn? Ooh, when am I going to receive what I've been praying for? And God says, come on now. I say the best for last. I say the best for last. You like yours well done. He said, I want to make sure this thing is exactly how you prayed it to me, so you know that I'm the one that gave it to you. Catch that in your spirit. God said, I'm preparing your meal, but you about to eat. That wasn't even a part of my message. God said, but you about to eat. You about to eat. What you lost can't compare to what you finna gain in this season, baby. You about to eat. God said, you about to eat. Keep that same hunger and keep on moving forward. Keep on pressing, God said. Keep on pressing this season, baby. Your meal is coming and you about to eat. You about to be fulfilled. You about to be sustained. I don't care if you got $1. I've been seeing 11. So 11 of y'all need to sow 11. That was straight from the spirit. 11 people need to sow $11. And I'm going to pin the cash tag right on here. And it's always in the description. So make sure you read in the descriptions as well, because it always, like, even afterwards, God will always just give me something even more to go with it. Because he's not a God. He's just not going to give you a steak and not give you mashed potatoes and asparagus. And if you like it with toast, or if you want your sweet tea on the side, or your lemonade, baby, or whatever you like. God, he wants to make sure you're fulfilled. Come on now. Oh, glory to God. So you can't continue to complete the mission. But 11 people need to sow $11. Some of us got $1 to our name. Come on now. $1. And God wants you to take that $1 that you got and sow into this word. Take your $11 and sow into this word. And if some of y'all, I want to say three, because I just, you know, hear the number three, but I'm never sure. I don't never want to be sure of me. I'm just sure of him. And by you being obedient, you revealed that God is truly who he is. And look, that's just that. You do that for me. But anyway, three of y'all, $111. $111. God said, you got it. You know you got it. Sow into it. You don't have to know me. You know him. Sow into this word and keep your heart in expectancy for how God is about to blow your mind. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard, neither has it entered into man's heart. Glory to God. I love y'all. I'm praying for you. Be praying for me. Join my group, Sisterhood Formed by Faith, so that we can pray and connect together. Sisterhood Formed by Faith on Facebook. We would be so blessed to have you. I want you to come and share your experience, share your gifts that God has gifted you with. Use your testimony to uplift, support, empower, and motivate. I want you to feel secure and comfortable. You are not alone. Do you hear me? I don't care what state you in. I don't care where you at, who you doing it with. I want you to come. I want us to connect in the name of Jesus. Okay, I love y'all. I will see y'all in the next video.